Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'd, habati fillah, as a reminder to myself and my brothers and sisters, the importance of just remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dhikr of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and actualizing your worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through prayer, through sacrifice, through fasting, through all the various acts of ibadah or worship. Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentioned something very profound and very beneficial for us about the concept of worship, the concept of ibadah in Islam. He said, al-ibadatu kullu ma yuhibbuhu Allah wa yarda min af'al wa aqwal al-dhahir wa batin. He said, ibadah, it's a comprehensive term which refers to everything Allah loves and is pleased with, from those things internal and those things in external, meaning those everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you with and is pleased with, that this is a type of ibadah. And that's a comprehensive understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitab al-kareem, wa ilahukum ilahun wahid, la ilaha illa huwa ar-rahman ar-rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitab al-kareem, in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 163, He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and your Lord, wa ilahukum, ilahun wahid, He is one. He is one God. La ilaha illa huwa, there is no God worthy of worship except Him. Huwa Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most beneficent, the most merciful. Ahabati fillah, in this ayah, we see the Tawheed al-Uluhiyah, and we also see it is evidence for Tawheed al-Asma'i wa Sifat. And in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us acknowledge that He is one. Our Lord is one. And He also commands that we worship Him and Him alone. La ilaha illa huwa. There is no God worthy of worship except Him. So this is evidence that the worship, all worship, He's the only one worthy of worship. And all worship goes to Him, tabarak wa ta'ala. And Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, that He is the most beneficent and the most merciful. So we can come back to Allah. The door of repentance is open for us. If we acknowledge our Lord, if we worship our Lord, if we come back to Him and seek His forgiveness and seek His favors and His bounties. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.